Hey guys, today we're going to show you how to remove the radio bezel in a fifth generation RAM. Now, when it comes to interior disassembly, as far as full-size trucks go, I would have to say Rams are probably my favorite. They haven't changed too much in essence since 2009 as far as their formula. So the materials have gotten better over the years, but they're basically of how things are attached and how things come apart is still the same. Now, Ford and Chevy, you need to pay attention to this video because as far as outfitters go, we make recommendations to fleet owners of what vehicles they should buy based on how we can work on them and how durable they are. So with the RAM, this is a very easy disassembly process. What you're gonna do is you're gonna take off this top part. Since 2009, they've been doing this. So you have two fasteners up here, and then we just go ahead and remove them. After you remove the fasteners, technically all that's holding on this bezel and the screen and your HVAC controls are just clips. You could just pull on it, however, if the vehicle's version, those clips are gonna be very tight. Take a pry tool and you're gonna start massaging the panel out. Now these clips do make some ugly noises, so be careful. And as you're prying it, you want to pry towards you. You don't want to pry up. You want to exert as much of your energy on the clip so that it releases. As you can see, we have tons of room. The head units are very small. So this is for the standard stereos and those 8-inch plus or 8.4-inch screens. But this is what I like about what Ram has done, or Mopar has done, is they still stick with their traditional formula. It has changed over the years, but like two fasteners, a bunch of clips, and it's come out. Whether you want to add aftermarket or you want to do some sort of head unit upgrade or even servicing, this makes life a lot easier. So for me, one of the top reasons to remove the radio bezel is to access the rear wires of this 12-volt access point. These vehicles are so computer controlled now, and Ram used to put the power plug roughly in this area. They've moved it up here. So once I remove this, it's easy to run wires up. Let's say you're adding a dash camera, you need remote turn on for a stereo. I really do prefer 12 volt turn on for aftermarket stereos as opposed to signal sense. I think it's more reliable, but it's easy to get it from here. And there you guys have it. That's how you move the radio bezel in a fifth generation Ram.